So recently we did a video on monitor response time, and it has been getting a lot of response and view time from you guys, especially when it comes to YouTube, which is why we did a little bit more digging into our messages and comments, and we found out that other than response time, one most common question that comes from you guys when it comes to gaming monitors is this: which is better, DyAc or GSync? And why should you care? That is kind of like asking which is better, your mother or your girlfriend. They're both important to players like you, but serve completely different functions. I mean, you and I both know that they don't play well together. Which is why today, I'm gonna explain to you what DyAc actually is, technically. With the holidays, next-gen consoles, as well as new processors and graphics card coming out, if you want to win the best wife, mother, boyfriend, girlfriend, husband award out there, you will be shopping for a new gaming monitor. But before you go out there and buy one, I suggest that you check out our previous monitor response time video before watching this one. Go lah, wait for what? Are you done? Can I continue now? Okay, so today, we're gonna settle the score once and for all. What is the difference between DyAc and GSync? And we are going to start with the one that most of you guys will have trouble finding. The GSync. What are you thinking? Hiya! So what the flying nasi dagang Ramli double special cheese is GSync? Well, GSync is a proprietary technology from Nvidia that was designed to deal with screen tearing, juddering, and stuttering, which is pretty much the same thing. Anyways, GSync being an Nvidia technology only works with Nvidia graphics card. With AMD, we have something called FreeSync that only works with AMD graphics card. Both GSync and FreeSync use the VESA Adaptive Sync protocol and are functionally the same. So now that we understand what all the sync means, let's take a closer look at what DyAc is. Before I dive any deeper, let me go and retrieve my very expensive blackboard, which is the BenQ Zowie XL2546K. But what does DyAc stand for? Very easy. DyAc stands for Dynamic Accuracy. But what does DyAc Plus stand for? Dynamic Accuracy Plus law. Like this also don't know. Jokes aside, tilde, DyAc or DyAc Plus is a solution designed by Zowie to combat motion blur. A motion blur can be very distracting, and they are actually observed mainly on LCD screens, and especially when you play first-person shooters and there is vigorous screen movement when you discharge or spray your weapon. Now, you might not care about this if you're not a competitive gamer, but if you're a very serious competitive gamer, this could mean the difference between walking away with $500,000 or walking away in shame into tubs of Ben and Jerry ice cream. Wow, that escalated quickly and sounded too close to home. DyAc was tuned by Zowie with the help of professional players that they've invited to test their products to help combat issues like that and improve recoil control, giving users the best technical performance in a gaming monitor. Now that we all know what's the difference between DyAc and GSync, let's find out how DyAc works. For those of you guys who are seasoned, retro, or vintage enough, you might know what a CRT monitor is. CRT, or cathode ray tubes, are basically vacuum tubes with one or more electron guns inside, as well as a phosphorescent screen. What is an electron gun? What is phosphorescent screen? For that, I'll leave them up here so you can have a read. If I grandfather story you all these technical terms, by the time I'm done, you'll be married with kids, bro. Anyways, a CRT is actually used to modulate, accelerate, and deflect electron beams onto a screen to create images. The speed in which this happens is actually called refresh rate, and it could be 50Hz, 60Hz, and whatever. In between showing a frame or image, the CRT is actually turned off, and this entire thing creates something called flickering or strobing, which could be more or less noticeable depending on the person, as well as the size of the monitor. Now, for most CRT monitor sizes, research has shown shown that a 72Hz and above refresh rate would be less noticeable in terms of the flickering for the majority of users.
So Shane, what does this ancient CRT technology have to do with DyAc? Why are you telling me all this grandfather story?
Bro, chill first, listen to me, okay? In comparison to CRT, which has all these cool electron guns that fire and stop in succession, a LCD or liquid crystal display is constructed with some sort of panel at the front as well as a backlight. Now this could be TN, IPS, VA and all that stuff. But what are the difference between all this stuff? Again, check out our previous video and you will find out. So essentially in an LCD screen, as a light beam from the backlight passes through a liquid crystal, a pixel becomes visible. When you see a moving object on a screen, what you're actually observing is the act of the light beam passing through multiple liquid crystals. Cool eh? Motion blur occurs because the liquid crystals are unable to turn off fast enough, resulting in the previous image still staying on the screen for a short while. While higher refresh rate as well as low latency panels continue to be developed, motion blur in LCD screens are still unavoidable. In fact, when it comes to motion blur, the ancient old is gold CRT tech is actually still better than the more modern LCD. Conventionally, an LCD monitor will actually show a black frame in between displaying images, but because the black frame is actually not completely black due to the backlight technology, you would still see a residual image and that would cause a motion blur. DyAc attempts to simulate the CRT's strobing effect, and I hope that none of you have epilepsy. So basically, Zowie uses DyAc to control the backlight by switching it on then off. When they switch off the backlight in between frames, that would eliminate any after image that might linger, just like any of your ex-boyfriend or girlfriend that stay around after you say goodbye to them. From the previous frame due to the residual light or your previous relationship due to your baggage, thus reducing motion blur. An LCD screen is actually a pretty standard component, but what Zowie is doing here is customizing the panel as well as making some modifications to the circuitry and programming in tandem to their backlight control technology, and it accumulates to what we call DyAc. So finally, why should you care? As we said, DyAc is highly beneficial to FPS games, and if you're an FPS player, here are some ways that DyAc could make a difference in your life, provided that you're not a noob with a trashy KD. In which nobody can help you. In CSGO, DyAc or DyAc Plus will help with spray control by reducing motion blur that results from very fast in-game actions such as bullet spraying. Gamers will be able to see the position of the crosshair and impact points much clearer as demonstrated by this demo video. In Valorant, some characters like Jett move extremely fast. By reducing motion blur, DyAc or DyAc Plus helps render the background or crosshair more noticeable, resulting in better aim. I was actually genuinely surprised about how well DyAc was being explained on the Zowie page. To be honest, I've checked out a lot of monitor products and their official websites, and they are usually filled with a lot of marketing gimmicks or misleading information, and I feel that that sometimes distracts from genuinely good products that they have put out. So kudos to Zowie. If this video helped you out in any shape or form, feel free to like and share it to your friends. Subscribe and hit the notification bell on our YouTube channel to see more content like this. Also, follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew. And I will see you in the next one. Oh yeah, don't forget about our Cyberpunk pre-order. Bye!